here's our pre-dug hole. So we've dug a deeper ditch here to try and catch some of the sediment. So if we collect past that, in theory, so we've got a big hole here that should trap some sediment, and we've got a second hole here. So we gently collect that. The water's still looking a bit murky. Right. Now I've got, always working with like a two-pot system. This is for dirty water. This is for boiling the water. And then like kettles and stuff is for clean water only. Get me trusty Shimaog. Seems pretty waterproof. Well, if you think the time of year, there's no crops, they're not crop spraying, there's no farms or cattle around here, so you're not going to get E. coli in the water from...
The majority of the run-up is going to be gone by now.
And it rained like hell yesterday, so that's all fresh water. Yep. There's no stagnant ponds around here.
Yep.
So, yeah, boiling it's fine. Just get it above 100 degrees to kill all the pathogens.
Well, it's clearer.
Fancy a brew.
And now we wait
for the ambulance. Just feeling my breasts. Quite firm. From when it starts percolating, it's supposed to be about 7 or 8 minutes. You can leave it longer, but then it just turns into syrup.
Stand your spoon up in it.
Yeah.
How did you take your coffee?
Get off. In an empty a few mug. Milk straight from the Tesco's tree. I foraged this morning.
fresh from the udder.
Lovely job.
Ah, muddy coffee.
Yeah.
It looks exactly the same as it did when it started.
There's a lot of grounds in that.
I washed it out. Oh, you're having a Frappuccino.
Yeah. That's fine.